puppy. Are you liking the snow? Are you liking the snow? Hi, Ron Spomer here at Dancing Springs Ranch with another optics topic. And it's a new binocular called Rite-On. That's the name of the company, Rite-On. I never heard of it until last year. It is owned by some military vets, and I always like to support our veterans for what they've done for us. The least I can do is look at their products. And this one is pretty impressive, really. It's a 10 by 42, and at first I thought, yeah, this is not going to be much. But by golly, when I started looking through this thing, I was really impressed. It's sharp, it's bright, it feels good, got smooth function throughout. It just looks like it's well made and it feels good and solid. But look how small it is. Now, I like to compare binoculars against a known quantity, and boy, you can't much beat a Swarovski EL binocular. This is also a 10 by 42. So these both have exactly the same power and exactly the same diameter objective lenses. Wow. Pretty small right here, right? So if you're looking for a more compact binocular, this is one you might want to consider. Now, what is it that makes this Swarovski sell for $2,600, whereas this one retails for a suggested price of $600? Well, obviously the Swarovski is going to be a better binocular all the way around, but for the money, I am really impressed what this thing does. Here's what makes it work so well. First of all, it has fully multi-coated optics, and what that means is that they put anti-reflection coatings on all of the air-to-glass surfaces on the lenses. And there's probably five, maybe even six or seven lenses in here that have air-to-glass surfaces, and if those are not coated, they're going to reflect and lose 4% of the light that strikes them. You put all those multiple coatings of anti-reflection materials on here, and it increases your light transmission dramatically. That's what makes the biggest difference in a binocular's brightness. So, it has all of that. What else do you want in a good quality binocular? A good prism system. This is a roof prism binocular, same as this. And the roof prisms have to be made of the right glass to really have good high quality and sharpness. And that glass should be Barium Crown 4. Whatever that means, that's the top grade stuff. So this one has BAK4 prisms, and those prisms are phase coated, which is essential to keep the sharpness up. And they're also coated with a dielectric mirror. The mirror reflects the light as it bounces through that prism, and dielectric is as sharp and bright and high light transmission as you can get in a binocular. So there's really nothing lacking in this as far as materials. It also has HD glass, and that means high definition. What happens there is that it's a special glass that has a different level of refraction. The upshot is when light goes through a prism, it comes out looking like a rainbow. We've all seen that in windows and little prisms that sparkle and show a little rainbow coming out of them. Well, that rainbow of colors has to be brought back to the same focus point in order for you to see natural light on your object you're looking at. So if you don't want your deer to look like he's got a yellow halo all the way around him, HD glass will fix that. It just makes all the images stand out looking more crisp and sharp. Now, what else would you want in a binocular other than a compact size and good solid construction and smooth functioning on all the parts? Well, you'd want it to be waterproof and fogproof and dustproof. This one's guaranteed that way. It has the armor coating on the outside, so it's a little more rugged and tough. The housing itself is magnesium alloy. That's lightweight and tough. Eye cups are rubberized and they turn up. So you've got eyeglasses or not, you can fit it. And they also go to steps. They don't just slide all the way. They stop at steps. So you can lock them in wherever you feel comfortable with them. And something I really like is the diopter wheel is under the eyepiece, right there. That changes the individual focus for your eyes. If one eye is a little bit different than the other, you use the diopter to adjust it so that you're looking sharply with both tubes. And you only have to do that once in 10 years or 5 years. I mean, if your eyes aren't changing, they're consistent, you don't need to change that. So I'm just not real crazy about the binoculars that have that adjustment in the focus wheel, because I found that in many cases it's too easy to bump that wheel and then you end up changing your diopter instead of focusing on your subject. So that's pretty much what's involved in this little binocular. Now the exit pupil, because 10 power into 42 millimeters comes up with 4.2. That's the diameter in millimeters of the exit pupil. That's a little circle of light that comes out of the eyepieces. I have found with a bright binocular like this, with all those anti-reflection coatings and those good barium crown glass and dielectric mirror surfaces, all of that comes together to make this binocular effective. A half hour, 45 minutes after sundown, I can still see deer clearly. You know, obviously they're a little bit dim, but boy, the binocular is still performing in really low light. So I find that 4mm exit pupil is just about right for my general purpose hunting and viewing, birding, whatever I want to do. So it's not a Swarovski, $600 instead of $2,600. Hey, if I had $2,600, I'd get the Swarovski. But if I didn't, I'd give that right on a good look. I'm Ron Spomer with Ron Spomer Outdoors. Visit me at ronspomeroutdoors.com. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and we'll try to keep the reviews coming.